You never eat GM food in your life? 60% say no. 15% say I don't know. So they don't even know that they're GMOs in the food chain. So most people are 1 in 20. That should be most of you. Let's see. Be brave. Admit it. How many people are 1 in 20? Raise your hand. Go on. Raise your hand. 20 to 40. 40 to 60. 60 to 80. 80 to 100. Okay. Remember your number. All right? Remember your number. Now we're going to try something. I'm going to work hard to increase your number over the next 5 to 10 minutes. Okay? And you can resist and say, I'm not going to change. Or you can change. There's no right or wrong. I just want to show you, based on evidence, whether or not people change their diets. Genetically modified soybeans were engineered with a gene that they found in bacteria growing in a waste dump near, a chemical waste dump near Monsanto's factory, growing in the presence of Roundup herbicide. So they figured, great, let's put it in the food supply. So they took the gene out of the bacteria, which allowed it to survive the Roundup, normally kills the bacteria, put it into soybeans, and now the Roundup ready soybeans can be sprayed with Roundup herbicide and not die. And what happens is there's more herbicide sprayed on the Roundup ready soybeans. When they fed Roundup ready soybeans to rodents, a number of things happened in a variety of tests. When they looked at the organs, one scientist from Russia showed me a picture after we both spoke at the EU Parliament. I'll show it to you in a few minutes. Testicles change from pink to blue. Testicles also change. The cells changed in mice. That was for rats. Testicles changed in mice, including changes in the young sperm cells. Another study in Brazil found changes in the ovaries and uteruses of rats and changes in the hormone levels as expressed by the altered physiology of the rats. When they looked at the DNA of the embryos of the offspring of parent mice that were fed GMOs, it functioned differently. In Russia, they fed female rats genetically modified soybeans. More than half of their babies died within 3 weeks, compared to a 10% death rate among those that were fed non-GM soy. The babies were also smaller on average and could not reproduce in a subsequent study. In a hamster study, also in Russia, they fed hamsters for 2 years on GM soy, and by the third generation, most had lost the ability to have babies. They also died at fivefold rate of infant mortality. Some had hair growing in their mouths. How many changed their numbers? Raise your hand. Just checking. Anyone change your number? All right. They fed mice genetically, no question yet. They fed mice genetically modified soy, and there were changes in the pancreas. It produced less digestive enzymes. And there were changes in the liver, suggestive of a toxic insult. Soon after GM soy was introduced to the UK, soy allergy skyrocketed by 50%. When they fed it to rabbits, there were changes in every organ they looked at in terms of the enzyme levels. The soy has higher levels of the Roundup, and now they're finding detectable levels of Roundup in farmers and their children, in their urine. It's also contained in the soybean, consumed by us, and Roundup is now linked with cancers, birth defects, endocrine disruption, less sperm, abnormal sperm, and a number of other things. And it's being used in huge amounts. Has anyone changed their numbers recently? Raise your hand. Okay, just check. Genetically modified corn. It can be Roundup ready. It can be BT toxin. How many people are familiar with what BT corn is? Raise your hand. Okay, so there are two varieties of genetically modified crops. herbicide tolerant, designed to drink poison. You can spray the poison herbicide on the crops, they don't die. We explained that Roundup Ready is the most popular. And there is the poison producers, the pesticide plants, the ones that produce their own insecticide and kill insects by breaking open the stomachs of the insects and killing them. You see, they took a gene from soil bacteria that normally kills insects when you put it together into a spray and spray it on the crops. It's even used by organic farmers and forestry, and then washes off the plant and then biodegrades within a couple of weeks. They took the gene that produces the toxin, they put it into corn and into cotton, and they produced the toxin thousands of times the concentration of the spray form. They alter it significantly to make it more toxic, and it can be washed off. It remains inside every cell of the cotton and corn plants. And it's consumed by us in corn on the cob and in certain corn products. The reason why Health Canada claims that this is safe is because they say BT has a history of safe use as a spray, let's just put it right into the crop. If you read the can of BT that you can get at the gardening store, it says do not consume. And the one that's in the corn is thousands of times more concentrated. They claim that it has a history of safe use, but they didn't read their own peer-reviewed published studies from a Canadian research that showed that about 250 people who were sprayed with BT went to the hospital or had other allergic or flu-like symptoms when it was used for gypsy moths. And there are 250 in Washington State. When they fed BT in its natural form to mice, they had tissue damage and an immune response. So it doesn't have a history of safe use unless you want to selectively ignore some of the peer-reviewed published studies. Now, we're seeing evidence that the BT crops are allergenic and toxic. When they feed BT corn to mice, as it would happen with the Italian variant, there was massive immune system changes. Monsanto's own studies, BT corn to rats. Monsanto said it was fine, but when the raw data was reanalyzed by real scientists, they found signs of toxicity and immune system responses. Thousands of farm workers in India picking the BT cotton plants after harvest, or for harvest, get allergic reactions and flu-like symptoms. Some had to go to the hospital. I read an analysis of 23 of those farm laborers from doctors who did their examinations. And I read the peer-reviewed studies from Vancouver and Washington State, and it was interesting that the symptoms were identical. The people sprayed with BT, the people touching the cotton, loading the cotton on the trucks, leaning against it, cleaning the cotton, all had the same symptoms. And I can show you some pictures, which I will show you in a moment, of rashes all over the bodies. They allow animals to graze on the cotton plants after harvest. Thousands of livestock died in India after eating the GM BT cotton, but not the natural cotton. People living in the Philippines adjacent to a BT cornfield complained of skin, respiratory, and intestinal reactions and fever while the corn was pollinating. The same seeds were planted in four more villages the following year, the same symptoms returned during the time of pollination. Has anyone changed their numbers recently? The only human feeding study ever published on GMOs. They took seven human volunteers. They had colostomy bags. They had their lower intestines removed, not for the study. They fed them a GM soy burger and soy milkshake, looked into the colostomy bag, and were surprised to find how much intact genetically modified DNA had survived passage through the stomach and small intestines. It wasn't supposed to, because the biotech industry said, genes are destroyed during digestion, so gene transfer to gut bacteria is impossible. But oops, three of the seven volunteers, before they were fed the meal, inside the DNA of the bacteria living inside their intestines was the gene, from the bacteria found in the chemical waste dump near Monsanto's factory. That they had put into soybeans and had somehow, in some previous meal, transferred, along with the on switch called the promoter, into the DNA of the bacteria living inside their intestines and continued to function. They had Roundup Ready gut bacteria. This was in the UK, where very few people eat GM soy. So long after we stop eating genetically modified foods, we may still have genetically modified proteins produced inside of us. They stopped the research when they found that out. They never looked to see if the BT gene in corn chips might transfer to our gut bacteria, turning them into living pesticide factories. All right, that was 10 minutes. I'd like you to rate yourself from 1 to 100 how vigilant you'll be next week at avoiding genetically modified foods. How many people are low vigilance, 1 to 20? Raise your hand. 20 to 40? 40 to 60? 60 to 80? 80 to 100? Okay. I'm looking at you, you're looking up, I should have had you look around. There was a change. There was two or three people that were below 1 to 40. Most everyone was between 40 to 100. So I'm doing this for a reason. In 1999, a speaker at a biotech conference in San Francisco from Arthur Anderson, the company that was Monsanto's consultant, bragged about how they had asked Monsanto's executives earlier to describe their ideal future in 15 to 20 years, and the executives described a world in which 100% of all commercial seeds were genetically engineered and patented. And the company worked backwards from that goal to create the strategy and tactics to achieve it. They were planning to replace nature. At the same conference, another company actually projected that within 5 years, by 2004, 95% of commercial seeds in the world would be genetically modified. 3 weeks later, the gag order on Dr. Pusztai, Dr. Arpad Pusztai, was lifted. He was a scientist, the leading researcher in the world in his field, worked at the top nutritional research laboratory in the UK, one of the best in the world. And he was given a grant by the UK government to figure out how to test for the safety of genetically modified foods. They were on the market, but no one really knew how to test their safety. So he took genetically modified potatoes, engineered to produce an insecticide. It was supposedly completely harmless. And he took that GM potato and he fed it to rats with a complete balanced diet, fed another group of rats natural potatoes, and a third group of rats natural potatoes plus the insecticide that the GM potato produced. So you have GM potato, natural potato, plus an added insecticide. Only the GM potato caused damage. Here's Dr. Arpad Pusztai, and here's the intestinal walls on the right of the rats that were fed genetically modified potatoes. Here's the stomach lining. It took 10 days. They also had damaged immune systems, partially atrophied liver, and smaller brains, livers, and testicles. What caused the problem? It wasn't the insecticide. It was somehow the process of genetically engineering the potato that caused changes to create these problems. And he used the same process that's used to create the GM crops on the market. So his information was highly incriminating. It demonstrated that the crops on the market might be creating this type of reaction in us.